Have you ever wondered what's the most damage a Pokémon can do in one move? Well, the answer already exists, but there's no real consensus. No one's actually explained it step by step, so that's what we're gonna do. Hello everyone, my name is Roberto Cristian, but you may call me Robbie for short, and today we're going to answer this question. What is the most damage a Pokémon can legitimately deal in one move? To understand how to answer this question, first we need to learn how to calculate damage and how can we maximize damage output. Yay! Math. Luckily for you, I was an engineering major for my first 2 years of college before I got depressed, quit school, and my parents forced me to reapply into a major I actually liked because they had already spent the money. So I'm actually quite good at math.
This is the formula the games use. But this looks too complicated, so let's simplify it a little more. There!
Much better!
Lo sé, you're confused, lo noto en tu cara que estás perdido. Me too, but I'm gonna explain this in the most detailed way I can. We'll divide this into four parts. Let's take a level 50 Espathra, for example, using Psychic against a level 50 Flamigo. The first part refers to the user's level. Damage is equal to 2 times the user's level, represented by L, plus 10. Espathra's level is 50, and times 2 is 100. Then we add 10. All that adds up to 110, which you'll then divide by 250, and that gives us 0.44. For the second part, you take the user's attack or special attack stat, represented by A, and divide it by the target's defense or special defense stat, represented by D, respectively. In this case, let's assume both of these Pokémon have their respective stats maximized with individual and effort values. We'll take Espathra's special attack of 168, and divide that by Flamigo's special defense of 127. Which gives us 1.32.
Hey, hi, did you fall asleep? I don't normally curse in my videos because Daddy YouTube don't like that, but I didn't make this long ass video so you could fall asleep. Wake the up!
The third part refers to the base power of the move, represented by B. Here, we simply take the base power of the move, which in the case of Psychic is 90. If you had an item like Metronome or an ability like Pixelate, you would multiply the additional power from those onto this number. The last part is the modifier, represented by M, which by itself is a separate equation. Basically, the modifier is a product of all the different multipliers a Pokémon can receive. These multipliers can be any of the following: same type advantage bonus, type effectiveness, critical hits, a status condition, weather effects, the number of targets, other modifiers from specific moves or abilities, and a random integer between 0.85 and 1. In basic terms, all of these stack. For example, Espathra is a psychic type, which means it'll receive stab from using Psychic, adding 1.5 times the damage. Psychic is super effective against Flamigo, a fighting type, adding twice the damage. Let's say this hit was a critical hit, which gives another 1.5 times the damage, and that the random interval is 0.9. Our modifier equation would look like this. Now let's put all those numbers to the original damage equation, which would look like this. Using order of operations, we multiply 0.44 times 1.32 times 90, which gives us 52.27. We're still inside of parentheses, so 52.27 plus 2 is 54.27. Now we multiply the modifiers. 54.27 times 1.5 times 2 times 1.5 times 0.9 equals 219.79. But since damage is always rounded down, we simply drop the decimals. After all the calculations are made, you would find that Espathra dealt 219 damage to Flamigo.
You still with me?
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Good.
Back to the question at hand. What is the most damage a Pokémon can deal in one move? Well, Reddit user mx_tony actually found the answer years ago. A level 100 Shuckle can potentially deal the most damage in one attack by receiving the effects of Helping Hand from two allies in a triple battle, holding a Metronome, Power Trick, a skill swap into Protean to convert into an Ice type, another skill swap to Pure Power, and 6 stages of positive attack stat changes. Both of Shuckle's partners must later have the ability Flower Gift, and the weather must be sunny. The opponent is a level 1 Noibat under the effect of Forest Curse, with 6 stages of negative defense stat changes. On the 6th turn of Shuckle using a defense curl boosted Ice Ball, learned via Mimic, consecutively without any misses, because Ice Ball has an accuracy of 90, after landing a critical hit, it can deal 721,898,980 damage.
Now that's a lot of damage!
But we can actually do better. Unfortunately for us, Shuckle isn't available in Pokémon Scarlet and Violet. Other things that aren't available in this generation include the moves Ice Ball, access to Flower Gift, and Triple Battles. That's less modifiers that we can work into this equation. This scenario established Shuckle as this powerhouse damage dealer because of two main things. Its base defense of 230, which is the most any Pokemon has had, aside from Eternamax Eternatus, which has 250, but we don't talk about that. And its access to Power Trick, which switches its base attack stat with its base defense. I researched extensively and found that the same person already came up with an even higher answer more than a year ago. Why am I always late to these things? I also have to give credit to a YouTuber by the name of Phildrong, who contributed to this question, but je ne sais pas parler français, so I couldn't understand what he was saying. So I messaged Tony on Reddit and kindly asked them to explain to me what that process would look like.
Hi, this is Robbie while he's editing. I don't know anymore if the 700 million answer I found on Quora is correct because it includes me first in the calculation, while Tony's is only above 500 million. Let me know in the comments, or don't, because we have a higher answer now, so it doesn't matter.
Since the Indigo Disc DLC is officially out, I've updated the numbers and the Pokemon necessary to do this. We'd be using a team of 6 Pokemon per player. Those teams consist of the following. The first team should have Ratska, Arbeliva, Baxcalibur, Confined Hoopa, Basculegion, and the star of the show, Sudowoodo. The second team should have Oranguru, Regirock, Medicham, Smeargle, Meowscarada, and our victim, Happiny. Previously, I had written down Mew, but Mew is unable to learn Swagger in Generation 9, so I used Smeargle as a safe option instead. I'll explain what role each Pokemon plays as we go along. As the battle begins, the player starts with Rapska and Arbeliva, and the opponent starts with Regirock and Meowscarada. The first part involves the player's Rapska using Skill Swap to swap abilities with Arbeliva. Arbeliva's ability should be Harvest, which has a 50% chance to restore a used Held Berry at the end of each turn. Under sunny weather, however, Harvest will always activate, restoring the Rapska's Lepo Berry, which restores 10 PP to a move that drops to 0 PP. Once Rapska has Harvest for its ability, it will use the move Revival Blessing to revive any fainted Pokemon on its team. The opposing team could help with this process by having Regirock repeatedly knock out Arbeliva while Meowscarada and Oranguru switch between turns. Ideally, we want to knock out and revive Baxcalibur at least once. This will be important for later. Rapska will need to use Sunny Day every 5 turns to continue harvesting Lepa Berries. Rapska can also use Trick to give its held Lepa Berry to an opponent to restore PP and subsequently harvest one for itself. This is also important for when the moves Sleep Talk and Protect are necessary for stalling. Once the player's teammates have fainted and been revived 100 total times, which I clearly didn't do because nobody has time for that, we can switch into Sudowoodo and Basculegion. The opponent will have Regirock switch into Oranguru. Basculegion may then use the move Last Respects on the opposing Oranguru so that Sudowoodo can use the move Mimic to permanently copy Basculegion's Last Respects. This move is important, as Last Respects starts with a base power of 50, but increases in power by 50 more every time a teammate faints. When your teammates faint 100 total times, the base power of Last Respects reaches its maximum of 5,050. The player switches Basculegion for Rapska, and has Rapska use Skill Swap on the opposing Meowscarada to receive Protean. Rapska will use Skill Swap again onto Sudowoodo to give it Protean, then Sudowoodo uses Last Respects to turn into a Ghost type and receive a stab bonus from it. The player's Rapska switches to Confined Hoopa. The opponent switches Meowscarada for Medicham. Medicham should then use Skill Swap to give pure power to Sudowoodo. This next part will be annoying. Oh, you thought the Harvest Revival Blessing combo was bad? Wait till you hear this part! Regirock has the highest base defense of all Pokemon available, meaning it reaches a max of 548. The opposing Medicham will use Power Trick to switch its defensive and defensive stats, then use Baton Pass into Regirock to pass along these temporary stat changes. That means Regirock has now reached its maximum attack. The player's Hoopa will use Power Split on the opposing Oranguru, which will use Protect. Power Split takes the user's and the target's attack stats, adds them, and averages them equally to each other. Sudowoodo will use Copycat to copy Hoopa's Power Split, and you better pray to Arceus that it lands on Regirock, because Copycat picks a target at random. If it doesn't happen successfully, we stall for one more turn. Oranguru needs to use Protect when Sudowoodo uses Power Split, because we can't have Sudowoodo average its stats with Oranguru, or it will mess up the numbers. Once this part of the process happens successfully, the opposing Regirock switches into Medicham, and it repeats 7 more times until Sudowoodo reaches a maximum unmodified attack stat of 547. The opponent can now switch into Happiny and Smeargle. Smeargle will use the move Reflect type to turn into the type of its target. Happiny will then use Copycat to copy Smeargle's Reflect type. And you better pray to Arceus again that it lands on Hoopa. If it doesn't, try again until Happiny turns into a Psychic and Ghost type. Dios mio, this is so long! The player switches Hoopa for Baxcalibur, which will use Leer on Happiny to decrease its defense stat to its minimum, while Smeargle uses Misty Terrain. At the same time, Smeargle will use Swagger on Sudowoodo to increase its attack stat by 6 stages. Misty Terrain will prevent Sudowoodo from getting confused by Swagger. The opposing Smeargle will switch into Regirock. Baxcalibur will then continually use Glaive Rush on Regirock, while Happiny uses Seismic Toss to knock itself out to less than 10% of its total HP. This is why it was important to knock out and revive Baxcalibur earlier so that it would later start out with half HP from the Revival Blessing. This is it. We've reached the final 6 turns. Home stretch! With Baxcalibur down to less than 10%, the player will switch Baxcalibur into Rapska. At the same time, Sudowoodo uses Last Respects to knock its teammate, Rapska, allowing the player to switch back into Baxcalibur. The opposing Regirock switches into Medicham, which will survive the Sudowoodo's second Last Respects due to it holding a Focus Sash. Medicham will then use Endure to survive Sudowoodo's last third Respects. On the fourth Last Respects, Sudowoodo knocks out the Medicham, which allows the opponent to bring out Meowscarada. On the fifth Last Respects, Sudowoodo will target Meowscarada, which will survive thanks to its Focus Sash. On the same turn, Baxcalibur will use Glaive Rush to knock out the surviving Meowscarada, while Happiny uses Copycat to copy Glaive Rush. Baxcalibur should faint this turn, allowing the player to send out Arboliva while the opponent sends out Oranguru. On that fateful turn, Arboliva will use Helping Hand to boost the power of Sudowoodo's final Last Respects by 50%. Oranguru will then use Instruct on Arboliva, forcing it to repeat its same action. This final blow should land a critical hit and roll the maximum damage integer in order for Sudowoodo to deal the maximum amount of damage possible on this poor, defenseless Happiny. Poor thing! Finally, Sudowoodo would Terastallize into a ghost type to give it a x2 stab bonus on this final attack.
It's my money, and I need it now!
Shut the f*** up!
I have done extensive research and consulted Serebii's list of Pokemon's highest base stats current with the Indigo Disc DLC. I also ran the simulation on Pokemon Showdown twice on a smaller scale solely for the sake of illustrating my point. The footage from Pokemon Showdown took hours to record. This is the equation. Here are the values. Now let's insert the values into the equation. A level 100 Sudowoodo can potentially deal the most damage in one attack by receiving the effects of copying an ally's power split a total of 8 times to increase its attack stat from an opposing Regirock's power trick stats, a skill swap into Protean to convert into a ghost type, another skill swap into pure power, holding a metronome, Helping Hand twice in a double battle within the same turn, once from an ally and once from an opposing Pokemon's Instruct, a stat bonus from Terastallizing into a ghost type, and 6 stages of positive attack stat changes. On that 6th consecutive turn, after landing a critical hit and rolling the maximum damage integer, the most damage a Pokemon can deal in one hit is 2,004,803,184. That was a lot of math. My brain is fried. Please subscribe because this was a lot of work. Thank you so much for watching. Leave a like if you enjoyed this video. And as always, I appreciate you being here. Bye.